apologize if I am disturbing you. I have brought a meal for you to enjoy before giving you your dose of the tincture. Should you need a moment to make yourself decent, I shall wait out here. Are you covered? Very good. I am coming in. By the will of the invisible black, the sun has been swallowed into the night, and so I stand before you once again. How are you feeling this evening, my dear boy? Have your injuries been giving you much trouble as of late? I hope the medicines I left for you to take during the day were helpful in easing your burden. I can only hope that such a small comfort can lift your spirits in my absence. As much as I desire to tend to you, the care I can give is limited by the need to seclude myself from the sunlight. Else I would remain at your bedside all throughout the day and night. I suppose the quality outweighs the quantity in this case. However, let's not dwell on that for now. Here, please enjoy your meal. I believe that my skills in the kitchen have improved a bit during your stay here. Perhaps having someone to cook for gives one more of a sense of motivation. Do let me know if it is to your liking. I sampled the dish while I was preparing it. However, my palate is not as diverse as yours. Blood is all I require to continue living, so one's sense of taste naturally tends to adapt to that. I don't wish to put you off of your meal by discussing the finer points, so I will prepare your dosage while you eat. You ate quite a bit of it. I am pleased that you enjoyed it so, my dear. I shall take notes of what you liked and try to improve on what was lacking. Allow me to take this from you and set it aside for now. As we must move on to the more unpleasant parts of my visits. I know the tincture is, well, rather foul tasting. For all of its medicinal benefits, blood blossom extract unfortunately is quite bitter and more than a little sickly sweet. I've heard the taste being likened to a mixture of black licorice and overripe lemons, though I find it more akin to coffee grounds and pond scum myself. Oh, I know you don't like it, dear boy. I do wish there was something I could offer to make the experience less troubling. However, what your health could suffer by not drinking it worries me far more. I have prepared some honey water to help rid yourself of the taste, so please, ease my worries and bear it. Yes, drink deeply, and we can put this unpleasantness behind us. There, that's a good boy. You did so well. You've made me very happy. Here, the sweetness of the honey should take away the bite. and help to settle your stomach. And just like that, the difficult times are over. Now we can put that bit of nastiness behind us and look forward to greener pastures. On the topic of looking forward to things, since you have improved enough not to be confined to my, apologies, your bed, to celebrate, I have prepared a little surprise for you. It's nothing extravagant, but I thought we could enjoy some quality time together and settle in a nice spot in the garden to watch the moon lace vines bloom tonight. I believe that is a fine way to spend this gloaming veil. Ah, yes. Forgive me, dear. I occasionally forget you are non-native to Ebonmire. You see, tonight is the night of the fifth new moon of the year. This is a very important time of worship within the church. Many of our rituals take place during it, and it is considered to be the time when our spiritual connection with the void, and thus our God, is the strongest. The number five itself is also quite important to our religion. I'm sure you've noticed that the chantry has five walls instead of the normal four. There's also five stained glass windows, five verses to our chants, and so on and so on. I don't mean to bore you with the finer details, but just know that at this time every year, the priesthood hold a grand festival at the central cathedral. There's food and drink, dancing and games. Oh, it's simply delightful. However, since we are quite a long way from the festivities, and neither you or I can leave the grounds of this chantry, I have thought on the subject and decided to bring a small celebration here for you and I to enjoy. As I said, it's not as decorated as the proper festival. However, I believe that you will enjoy it nevertheless. It is what you do with what you are given that is the most important, don't you agree? So, if you wish, shall you accompany me in a walk in the gardens this moonless night, my dear? I thought you might agree. I have brought you a selection of my coats, should you wish to wear one, so that you might keep warm. I'll give you some privacy and wait outside. Once you are dressed and ready, we shall be off. Are you ready, dear? Oh my, this style of dress suits you well. You look rather dashing. Ah, your collar is a bit ruffled. Let me tidy that up for you. Just a tug here and there, and voila. You're ready for a night out. I shall stay close, in case you need to lean on me. I wouldn't want you to push yourself when your recovery is going so well. So, if you are feeling faint, please don't hesitate to tell me. Good. Now, come along. The night will not last forever, you know. of it, this is the first time you have properly seen the garden, isn't it? I have spent many, many years tending and cultivating it, growing all manner of things for any purpose I could imagine. It is my pride and joy. I'm glad you like it. Gardening has become a beloved hobby ever since I was relocated to this chantry. It gives me something to do in between my religious and clerical duties. Do you see this plant here? The leafy yellow one with the orange speckles around the edges? This is cinder leaf. When crushed and mixed with frock root, it makes the salve that I apply to help with your bruises. It can also be used on its own as a disinfectant, so it is rather common to find it paired with bandages to keep any wounds clean. And if you look just over there, that one with the pretty bright red flowers, that's your favorite, blood blossom. Oh. You don't need to make a face, dear. It's not going to come bother you for a while yet. Besides, it's not all that bad. The oils in the flower petals can be boiled out and distilled into a liquid that, despite its acquired taste, helps with nausea and also acts as a blood thinner, making it quite ideal for head injuries. All in all, it's a fine medicinal plant, if you would believe it. It allows for a more comfortable alternative to the more invasive treatments that are typically used when tending to mortal injuries such as yours. What do I mean? Well, vampires are given many abilities once we are embraced by Vanite. You have seen some of them already, and many more that you have not. One of these abilities can be used to speed up one's natural healing process by temporarily sharing a vampire's regenerative vitality with a mortal. It is a basic skill that many choose to overlook in favor of others. However, I have studied it thoroughly and find it quite useful should the situation demand it. There is a reason I have not used it in your case. In order to use this ability properly, there is a rather significant caveat. For it to be used, a mortal and a vampire need to be in both spiritual and physical contact. This is usually most easily done during a feeding. Yes, you see where the issue arises. I gave you my word that I would not harm you in any way. And while a feeding is not necessarily harmful, it can be uncomfortable or even painful if great care is not taken. I will not make a liar of myself simply to take the most efficient path. You have placed your trust in me to aid in your recovery, and that is not a small thing to me. I care for you too much to suggest such a thing without properly earning your trust. Ah, it's almost midnight. The moon lace should start blooming soon. Come. Let's take a seat underneath them on the bench here. Don't dawdle, we'll miss it. I wouldn't want to spoil the surprise, just watch the buds. They should start soon. Look, they're opening. You weren't expecting that, were you? Moonlace only blooms twice a year during a new moon, when there is no light in the sky. Yet its seeds make their own light and float on the air like little fireflies. It's like being in a sea of stars. And here, touch one. Yes, they are warm, aren't they? They drink sunlight for half a year and give it back through their seeds. That is why they shine as the brightest thing in the dark this time of year. I've always enjoyed it. I think this is the closest a vampire can get to feeling what it's like to stand in the sun again. I look forward to it more and more as the decades pass. This is nice. It's been some time since I've had anyone to share this with. Are you all right, dear? You're fidgeting with your collar a bit. Did I button it too tight? I apologize. Here, I shall loosen it for you. Oh, careful, dear. That's a bit too exposed, don't you think? That's just... what are you doing? Sure, and it's all right. I don't wish to hurt you or damage our relationship, so are you sure that you trust me to do this? All right. Are you okay with being out here during it, or you want to go back inside? Very well. Allow me to unbutton your collar all the way and lay bare your neck. This is your first feeding, so I shall be taking my time with the preparation. Of course I will prepare you. I'm not a brute who will just drink from you right off the bat. This is already going to be an intense experience, so I will take care to make sure that you are ready. Right here, where my fingers are, this vein starts from the collarbone and trails all the way up to your shin here. Here is where I will bite. But first, I shall lay a few kisses upon your neck to relax you. You seem to be enjoying yourself, dear. Do you like when I run my tongue up and down your flesh. You shudder ever so slightly when my fangs brush against your skin. You're almost ready. Keep looking at the lights, dear. I will begin in just a moment. There will be a bit of pain at first, but since I've prepared you, it should fade quickly and be replaced with a comfortable pleasure. Are you ready? All right. Rest on me, my dear. I shall hold you the entire time. Let's begin. Still awake? Oh, good. I was afraid you had fainted. How did it feel? Any pain or discomfort? Oh, did it now? Well, I'm happy that you enjoyed it too. No, don't get up just yet. You've lost quite a bit of blood, so let's just stay like this for a bit. I'll hold you and stroke your hair while we watch the lights float away. Aftercare is the most important thing, don't you know? That you trusted me enough to do this experience. You did so very well, and I couldn't be more proud of you, dear. You were very, very brave. Shh, just rest for now. We'll go back inside when you're ready. Unless you'd like for me to carry you again. Shush, dear boy. Let's bask in the afterglow and just live in this moment for as long as we can. And dear, thank you for making my night.